and the 13th verse. According to Apostle Paul, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Thank God so much for that scripture, because it's considering myself. Because whosoever could be you, me, or anybody that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I believe God's power is all significant. He can deliver junkies, drunks, thugs, pimps, and prostitutes. He can save gang members, rapists, hoodlums, and thieves. He can heal all diseases, including cancer and AIDS. This is no time to be playing church. It's time to take God's power to the peoples, the taverns, the pool rooms, the streets, the lounges, out where the sinners are. It's time to face Satan head on. God's power can't be denied. I challenge the devil to do his worst, to send out his hardest attack. We give the devil God's best, healing and deliverance, and freedom in the Holy Ghost. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Amen. We are so blessed. Most of us have plenty to eat, a comfortable place to live, opportunities to go where we want to and do what we like, and freedom to worship God as we choose. Sometimes I think we Americans believe that we invented the concept of liberty. But that's not so. Freedom is God's idea. The devil has always tried to oppress, to afflict, to bind, to deceive, to enslave, and imprison mankind. But from the beginning, God has been our deliverer, our healer, our liberator. God sent his son to break the power of sickness and sin, to set the captive free. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. He said, if the son, therefore, shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Have you been set free, my brothers and sisters? Have God saved you from sin, healed your sickness and pain? Do you have victory over sin one day and backslide the next? Are you healed from one sickness only to come down with something else? Do you need to know how to stay free? The Apostle Paul said, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. And be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. God's word wouldn't tell you to do something that is impossible. This means then that not only can you be set free, you can also stay free. To every temptation, you don't have to backslide. By faith, you can stay free in body, soul, and spirit. You can stay free from sin, from sickness, from tormenting spirit, from poverty. You can be victorious over the devil every day of your life. Amen. You can live for God and do great things for the Lord. You can be overcomers. You can live in peace, free from fear. The answer you've been looking for are in the Word of God. It's in the Bible. The covenant for which God has left for his children. The Lord has shown me, Bishop Magic Wand, his formula from freedom, for freedom. These powerful portions of his word contain the secret of getting free and staying free. I'm telling you, this is dynamite. If you ever want to know how to walk free, you must read the word of God. Jesus took our infirmities and bared our sickness. He was wounded for our transgression, bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. We are all like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned every one of us to our own way. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he's near. Let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Jesus has come to set us free. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. God is asking you to set your house in order. You are not in bondage to the devil or sin or sickness or anything that's not right with God. Very often God will tell us the thing that we need to know in order to make it in a world that is going backwards. I want you to know that the word of God said, lean not to your own understanding and acknowledge God and he will direct your path. The only righteousness that is really good is the righteousness of God imparted to us by faith. God's spirit is in us. Only thing that will satisfy the hard hunger. The only thing that can warm, fill the human soul with joy and happiness. Our righteousness will not save us. We must repent, surrender to God, come to him through Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. And then and only then God promised to beget us with his Holy Spirit. God's Spirit is his very life, his love, his understanding, his wisdom, his power, his faith, and his righteousness. Through the very power of God imparted to us, we develop spiritual readiness to be with God, born of God, by resurrection, converging from mortal to immortal, from human to divine, from weakness to power, from dishonor to glory.